nothing complicated about the way we live. We're all here for each other, happy to give, proud of who we are, humble beneath the stars.
Starting back how many years ago, how it's morphed into such an event now, it's mind-boggling.
I am still in awe of everything that takes place at every single event that I attend.
Anything that you give them, no matter how small it is, it's so appreciated. It's magnified so many times with these kids.
All we have we share, and all of us we care. So come on, welcome to our family time. Welcome to our brotherly time.
It began in 1984, when 40 officers ran through 8 New Jersey counties, covering some 43 miles, raising $7,000.
I remember it well because we started 3 o'clock in the morning. Not only didn't we have anybody cheering us on, we had people yelling, "Keep quiet." We got a little better at it as it went on.
Who could ever have predicted the astronomical growth of the law enforcement torch run for Special Olympics New Jersey, or the effect it would have on the athletes, the program, and the officers involved? Today, nearly 3,000 runners carried the torch over 800 miles through literally every county in the state, raising millions of dollars and setting the stage for the dramatic entrance of the Special Olympics flame into opening ceremonies at the annual Special Olympics New Jersey Summer Games. For Torch Run participants, their passion and dedication to these athletes is unconditional, undeniable, and year-round. Through the years, law enforcement officers have run thousands of miles, raised millions of dollars, presented countless medals, and received an equal amount of love and respect in return. But that's just the beginning. You see, through the years, New Jersey law enforcement has proven that there is no limit to what they will do in support of Special Olympics. They've pulled airplanes, hosted golf tournaments, rode on big rigs and on motorcycles, closed down bridges to Philadelphia, closed down the Lincoln Tunnel to New York City. They pose for promotional posters and then hit the streets to get out the word. They run by the thousands into freezing oceans in the dead of winter and run thousands of miles in the heat of summer. They run backwards and forwards through city streets and suburban neighborhoods. They have stood in 100-degree heat, biting cold, pouring rain, and driving snow. In the name of Special Olympics, they have been known to dress up as lobsters, polar bears, and who knows what else. They are color guards, torchbearers, cooks, directors, organizers, chaperones, announcers, and cheerleaders. Ultimately, they are role models, mentors, heroes, and friends dressed in a uniform that Special Olympics athletes revere. That in itself is a rare quality today.
That uniform represents to them more than these law enforcement officers go out and raise money for us. It means friend. It means a relationship. It means that we're there for them and we always will be.
Each year, New Jersey law enforcement makes a dramatic entrance into opening ceremonies of the Summer Games. Their sheer numbers are impressive, but even more so is the sincerity of their commitment, their passion for this program and for these athletes. You can see it and feel it time and time again in an athlete's high five, an athlete's hug, or even a ceremonial salute.
The biggest way of getting caught up is and getting on board is coming to any opening ceremony. And if that doesn't grab you, nothing else will. To see the families, to see the athletes marching in, and to see a place where we in law enforcement are appreciated for what we do.
Perhaps the most memorable moment in the history of the Torch Run occurred at the first summer games following the tragic events of September 11th, 2001. Somehow, someway, these remarkable men and women from every branch of New Jersey law enforcement showed up in force for their athletes. And in many ways, the athletes, more than ever, showed up in force for them. Each stood proudly and waved their flags in recognition of those lost and for those who came that weekend. It was a moment few would ever forget.
No one was untouched by this event. They knew someone, they were related to someone, and we needed to go back to what we do best, and that is get all the officers back together and do something for the people who died at the World Trade Center. And that's what I did. I asked them to do something for all the officers we lost. They got together and they had one of the best years in the history of torture.
So it is clear that over the past three decades, the relationship between Special Olympics and New Jersey law enforcement has become so much more than a fundraiser. And the results have gained international recognition. Every 4 years, Special Olympics International holds their World Games. And New Jersey officers have been invited to be part of the International Torch Run in recognition of their statewide success. The fact is that the New Jersey Law Enforcement Torch Run has become the standard bearer for all torch runs worldwide. Today, Special Olympics is in over 170 countries, and the torch run from the tiny state of New Jersey has been number one for the past 4 years running. With every mile, with every dollar, and with every volunteer moment, you make a difference in the lives of thousands of athletes and their families. It is an instant gratification rarely seen or felt anywhere else. We welcome you to be part of this success story, to be part of this very personal story of the New Jersey Law Enforcement Torch Run for Special Olympics New Jersey.
It only takes one time for one athlete to throw their arms around you and give you a big hug, and it's just, the feeling is overwhelming. It's not anything that can be duplicated anywhere else.
Rewards of what we see in their face, and that's why we do it.
It's just a perfect relationship.
It's fantastic, and it brings back memories of my sister, who was in Special Olympics, who passed away last year, and it just was very emotional for me.
The officers in the New Jersey Torch Run have the enthusiasm just like the athletes have when they're competing. It's endless.
We're one big law enforcement family. It's great.
It's more. It's just more than just raising money. Now it's a kinship between law enforcement and the athletes of New Jersey.